The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
EPA approval for graphene products are pretty rare. There's probably only one or two that otherwise have it. We now have the approval conditions in hand, and we've got to now go through the process of signing it, which would take a short amount of time, only weeks. So we should have an approval consent notice, which will mean we'll be able to sell our graphene coating into the US.
Welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Craig Nicol. He is the CEO of Graphene Manufacturing Group. And Craig, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Yeah, great. Thanks, Steve. Good to be back on.
Yeah, so I know you've had a couple of pieces of news that we're going to talk about in just a second. But first, maybe for those not totally familiar with the company, remind everyone a little bit about the company.
Yeah, GMG is a clean technology manufacturing company. We make graphene from our own process of natural gas. And then we go and make that into a number of energy saving and energy storage products, which is a coating, a lubricant additive, a battery additive, and a very new next generation battery.
And so you're announcing today that you've been getting EPA approval, which is a real milestone for the company. So maybe explain what this approval is and what it means and what the technology is it's approving.
excellent question. So EPA approval for graphene products are pretty rare. There's probably only one or two that otherwise have it. We now have the approval conditions in hand, and we've got to now go through the process of signing it, which would take a short amount of time, only weeks. So we should have an approval consent notice, which will mean we'll be able to sell our graphene coating into the US for coating products, for air conditioning, data centers, various other different type of heat exchangers, with basically no limit, which is a huge, I guess, validation of what we're doing, and also that, you know, the government thinks it's safe. It's otherwise legal to sell around the world. America was the last country to get the approval. So this is really completes our global opportunity for approvals, which is really, really exciting because it's obviously a global product that could help heat transfer and reduce corrosion of any heat exchanger there is in the world.
And the key to that is, in the end, it's saving money, right? I mean, this allows companies, and that's the key to this, is that people will try new technology, but they know it's going to help with the bottom line.
Yeah, that's exactly right. So we typically see 10 to 20% reduction on air conditioning bills with our coating. It can be applied in situ, so on the building. It can also be applied in factory. And we have a number of large companies in America already testing the product, which is very exciting. It's kind of when you see what our product can do, there should be no other way that every air conditioning coating or every heat exchanger or data center air conditioning system or radiator should be coated with our product. It makes it so much more efficient and stops corrosion, which are the two things that keep, concerns about this industry and make people up, you know, thinking about how can they, you know, reduce costs. Those are the two things it tackles.
Yeah. So let's just give a quick update here on the commercialization. So you're expecting the first shipment to come early in the new year?
Yeah, we've already got orders in with our partner, Nicol, who has over 4,000 ship-to points in Canada, America, Mexico, and Caribbean. They've been pumping, I guess, their opportunities with their companies, their customers for some time. The product was launched over a year ago. So it's very exciting to be able to actually start talking now on the exact parameters of that product launch, physical product launch now in early new year.
All right. We look forward to having a conversation when that happens as well. Get more on that. We should also mention that you had an update also recently on your battery demonstration, the aluminum ion battery technology. Let's update everyone on that.
Yeah, so basically our battery technology uses only aluminium ion instead of a lithium ion, and it provides a opportunity to get a really fast charging, safe battery and long life battery with quite a low cost. There's really no battery that does that right now in the world. The only battery that it's similar to is what's called a lithium titanium oxide battery, which is what's called LTO. Which is about $6 billion a year currently of these batteries are sold a year. They're very fast charging. Our battery can charge in 6 minutes, which is one of the very few in the world that can do that. And we'll continue to progress its development over the next year. we look to go into commercial production in 2027. It's a very simple battery to make, very low cost battery, long life, and very fast charging. Changes the way we believe customers will work with batteries, because it's no longer many hours to charge. It's literally minutes. So it changes the way actually batteries can be worked in many different scenarios. So it's very exciting. We've got lots of different big companies wanting to work with us. We just got to get this technology to the next level, which we're definitely progressing now.
Well, it sounds like it's going to be a pretty busy 2026. A lot of change for the company coming.
Yeah, a lot of really exciting points. We've got a number of products that have gone into now full commercialization. We've got our small packs for our products, which have got an opportunity to get significant revenue next year. We've got our opportunity for revenues with our Bayo Ref launch, which is an air conditioning distributor, which we've just announced in Australia, so that all air conditioning refrigeration systems can now be coated with our coating in Australia. And now we've got our product launch in America, which is definitely the largest air conditioning coating product market in the world. So three big opportunities coming through after many, many years of work, and obviously our battery progressing as well.
Absolutely. Greg, thanks so much. Good update. Good to see you as well. Best of the season, and we look forward to more conversations in the future, okay?
Thanks, Steve. Same to you.
All right. There's Craig Nicol, the CEO of the very busy Graphene Manufacturing Group.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.